Hi students, today we solve the exercise on the lesson time. Okay, dear student, this is the first exercise on the lesson time chapter, the exercise 14.1. Dear student, I read the first question. If 365 days are there in a year, which is not a leap year, how many days are there in a leap year? Dear student, if 365 days are there in a year, which is not a leap year, how many days are there in leap year? Dear student, you already know in your previous class what is leap year and how many days present in a leap year. Therefore, there are 366 days in leap year. Dear student, there are 366 days present in a leap year. Dear student, then come to the second question. Examine whether the following years are leap year or not. Dear student, the sum of the years are given. You find out these years are leap years or not. Dear student, I already told in your previous class how to find out the leap year. Dear student, any year is given, you observe last two digit of the year. The last two digit can completely divided by 4. That is, we called as a leap year. Dear student, the first one is 1908 year is there. So, we observe the last two digit, 8 and 0 is there. 0, 8 is completely divided by 4. Therefore, it is a leap year. Then come to the second question. 2003 is leap year or not, you find out. You observe first last two digit of the year, 03. 03 is not divided by 4. So, it is not a leap year. Dear student, third one, 1972 year. So, you observe the 72, last two digit, it is completely divided by 4. That's why it is a leap year. And 1990, we observe the last two digit 90. The 90 is not completely divided by 4. So, it is not a leap year. And 2013 is the last digit, it is not completely divided by 4, that's why it is not a leap year. Okay, so then come to the third question. Okay, dear students, in the third question, how many leap years are there from 2013 to 2025? Dear student, you find out how many leap year comes between the year 2013 to 2025. Dear student, 2013 is not a leap year because 13 is not completely divided by 4. That's why 2013 is not a leap year. Then 2014 is also not a leap year. 2015 is not a leap year. 2016 is a leap year. Dear student, 2016 is a leap year because 16 is completely divided by 4. So, then for leap year comes every four years once. That's why 2016, then the leap year comes after 4 years. 2020 is also leap year. Then after 4 years leap year comes, so 2024. There are 3 leap years comes between the year 2013 to 2025. Okay, dear student, next question. How many days are there in 2014? How many days are there in 2014? Dear student, 2014 is not a leap year because 14 is not completely divided by 4. That's why it is not a leap year. Therefore, 365 days present in the 2014. Okay. Then we find out the next answer to the next question. That is fifth question. First I read it. How many years once in can the birthday be celebrated for those who are born on the February 29th date in the leap year? Dear student, you already know in your previous class the leap year comes every 4 years once. That time the leap year having February 29. The February 29 is comes every 4 years once because it is a leap year. Therefore, any one of the person born on February 29, he celebrate his birthday every 4 years once. Therefore, the 4 years once birthday be celebrated for those who are born on the February 29th date in the leap year. Okay. Then come to the next exercise, that is 14.2. So this is also exercise on the lesson time. The sum of the examples are there, 14.2. Write the following time in anti-meridian or post-meridian. Okay. The first one, evening 4:50, it is a PM. Because I already told in your previous class when we use the PM and when we use the AM. AM is used afternoon 12 to night 12. It's right or wrong? It's right or wrong? Wrong. Dear student, you listen carefully. The PM is used for the timings start afternoon 12 to midnight 12. The timings between afternoon 12 to midnight 12, we can use the timings in PM. When we use AM, we can use AM after midnight 12 to afternoon 12. The timings we referred as a AM. Okay. Yes. The sum of the timings are given. You put AM or PM. Evening 4:50. Evening 4:50, it is a PM. Morning 7, it is a AM. 13. 13 is in 12-hour clock. So 13 is in 12-hour clock or 24-hour clock. It is a 24-hour clock. So it's converted into 12-hour clock. So you can subtract 13 from 12. So it is a 1 o'clock. It is in a PM. So 17:30, it is also 24 hours clock. You can subtract 17:30 minus 12. So you get the time and write the PM. Okay. So this is the mentioning of the AM and PM. Dear student, the second main is one of the activities or the Lakshmi's daily activity is given right in the anti-meridian, post-meridian. Convert the time to 24-hour clock. Okay. So, dear student, Lakshmi gets up in the morning at 6 o'clock. It is in a AM. Takes bath in the morning at 6:30. It is also AM. She helps her mother to do the household work from 7 to 8:30. It is also AM. She goes to the school in the morning at 8:30. It is also AM. She take lunch at 12:30. It is a PM. She goes to the play at 5:30 PM. She sleeps at 9 o'clock in the night. It's a PM. Okay. So then come to the third question. These are the statement problem to convert the timings 12 o'clock. First one, in the railway timetable, the departure time is written as 19:30 hour. Write this as per a 12-hour clock. Therefore, you subtract 19:30 minus 12, you will get 7:30. It's a PM. The departure time 19:30. Write this as per 12-hour clock time is 7:30 PM. Then go to the second question. Dear student, I read the second question. So the arrival time of an aeroplane is written as 12 hours. Write this as per a 12-hour clock. 20 minus 12, it's a 8 p.m. The arrival time 20 is right as per 12-hour clock time is 8 p.m. Okay. Then come to the next exercise, that is 14.3. Okay. 14.3. Dear students, some of the activities are given. These activities completed how many times we taken for completed complete of these activities. Okay, the first activity, the time taken by you to play with your friends, you take a minute or hour, you take a hour. So the time taken to say the prayer, it's a in minute or hour, it's we take a 1 hour or half an hour. The time required to have breakfast in the morning, 30 minutes or 2 hours, 30 minutes only. The time required to build a house, days or months, months. Okay. Then, dear student, write any 4 activities that you do daily and time required to complete them. Dear student, I give some example. I brush the teeth required 20 minutes. I have breakfast required 30 minutes. To do the homework 2 hours. To prepare the food 1 hour. Okay. So then second question, that is make a list of any 2 activities for which the time can be said accurately. To take lunch 30 minutes accurately. To play the game, it is exactly 1 hour. Then come to the exercise 14.4. An exhibition was arranged from 7-9-12 to 10-9-12. How many days was the exhibition arranged? 4 days the exhibition was arranged, because the difference between these 2 days, 7-9-12 to 10-9-12. So you subtract 7-9-12 to 10 days, so it is the range between the days, 4 days, so the 4 days exhibition was arranged. Then come to the second question. For Ahmad school, the holidays were announced for 14 days from 2-10-12. After the vacation, on which day did the school reopen? 16-10-12, the school reopen date. The for Ahmad school, the holidays were announced for 14 days. So you count the dates from 2-10-12 to 14 days. So 14 days is completed, 16-10-12. Therefore, this is the school reopening date. Okay. So then come to the next question. Suresh went to on a trip from his school from 3-10-11 to 7-10-11. For how many days was he away from the school? 5 days. Because the difference between these 2 days, you will get the 5 days. So 5 days he away from the school from trip. Then Malati attended the preparatory examination in her school from 20-12 for 60 days. On which date did she complete her examination? Dear student, Malati attended the preparatory examination in her school from 20-12 for 6 days. You count the days from this date. So the 6 days become 26-12. So she complete her examination. Then next question. The next question is, Ramu did not attend the school from 1-3-12 to 3-3-12. How many days was he absent? He was absent 3 days. Okay. The difference between these 2 days are the number of absent days. So He was absent 3 days. So, dear student, these are the completion of the exercise on the lesson time.